In this video, we'll talk about some of the reasons why food may be freezing in the fresh food section of your refrigerator. We'll talk about how the refrigeration system works and some of the components that may cause this symptom. Now, the basic operation of a refrigerator is such that we have an evaporator, which is where the cooling portion of the system takes place, and it will be located in the freezer, whether it's a side-by-side, a top-mount, or a bottom-mount refrigerator. Air from that freezer is then circulated into the fresh food compartment and back into the freezer in a continuous circulation. Typically, we would see about 80% of the air stay inside of the freezer and about 20% go into the fresh food compartment. With that ratio, we typically will get a temperature range of about 0 to plus 5 Fahrenheit in the freezer and about 36 to 38 degrees Fahrenheit in the fresh food section. If your fresh food section is cooler than that, you can suspect that we have a problem with either the thermostat control, and that's the device that turns the compressor on and off. That thermostat monitors the temperature of the air either in the freezer or in the fresh food compartment depending on the model. And a typical hydraulic control for a refrigerator consists of a capillary tube that senses the temperature and a set of electrical contacts enclosed in a casing. If it becomes defective, it is a non-serviceable item and will need to be replaced. So first of all, verify that somebody hasn't inadvertently turned the temperature up too cold. Set it back to the manufacturer's recommended setting and allow about 24 hours for the temperatures to stabilize in your refrigerator. If that does not solve your problem, then you'll need to replace that control. Another reason why you may be experiencing freezing temperature in your fresh food section could be related to the damper control. Most modern refrigerators use an auto damper to control how much air comes into the fresh food section from the freezer. Normally about 20% will enter the fresh food section, but if the damper for some reason or other sticks in an open position, you may get more air enter the fresh food and the temperature will drop dramatically. The damper control is typically located in the top section of a side-by-side or in the midsection on a top-mount refrigerator, where freezer temperature air enters from the freezer into the fresh food section. It will either be a flapper type door behind this grill or a slide gate to regulate how much air actually comes into the fresh food. This is a typical auto damper used on a side-by-side refrigerator. This portion would be inside of the freezer, and there's a bit of a slide gate there that is operated by this electric motor. Now, if you're experiencing freezing temperatures in your fresh food compartment, you would suspect that that damper assembly should be closed up some if it's working properly. If it is wide open, that means that it is defective, or the sensor that controls that damper is defective. So first of all, make sure that there are no mechanical defects with it that is causing it to be jammed in an open position, and also you may wish to check the sensor that controls that motor. Now, if you determine that there does not appear to be any mechanical issues with your auto damper, the next thing we may suspect is the temp sensor that is associated with that. Most auto dampers will use some type of an electronic temp sensor to control the actual motor that drives the shutter or gate on that auto damper. The temp sensor is typically located somewhere close to that airflow and will often have some type of a connector on the end of it that it can easily be plugged in. Some manufacturers use a hardwired type of temp sensor, and it's simply a matter of cutting those leads and splicing in a new one if you need to replace it. To test a temp sensor, we first of all need the manufacturer's specifications for that particular sensor, and they will give an indication of the resistance of that sensor at a specific temperature. Normally they will show something for a room temperature and give you a specific ohm reading. So we simply need to take our multimeter, connect it to the leads or connector on that temp sensor, and then consult the chart to verify that the reading is what it is supposed to be. If you get a reading that is not consistent with the manufacturer's suggestions, you will need to replace that temp sensor. Another reason why your refrigerator may be freezing in the fresh food section could be related to an electronic control. Many modern refrigerators use electronics to control both the compressor, evaporator, and condenser fans in your refrigerator. Using sensors located throughout the refrigerator, that information is fed back to an electronic control to operate those devices. If the control interprets that data improperly, it may turn on the compressor and fans when they're not necessary. To troubleshoot whether the control is at fault, you first of all need to locate that control. On some models, it is located in the control housing at the front. In other models, it may be located on the rear of the refrigerator. Now, this is a typical model that has the control board mounted at the back of the refrigerator. With the access panel removed, we can then identify where each of the leads are for the individual temp sensors or thermistors located throughout the refrigerator. We can trace those back to the appropriate connector, or we can disconnect that connector and we're able to measure the resistance of those individual thermistors to verify whether they're working properly or not. If we've identified that the thermistors are working normally, we can then suspect that we have a defective control board and that can be replaced. Need help with anything else around your home? Search our channel for thousands of helpful videos that will walk you through your home repairs. For more information or the parts needed for these repairs, don't forget to check out PartSelect.com. Thank you so much for watching, and remember to subscribe.